Hello and welcome to another Algebra 1 video tutorial. In lesson 12.7 we'll be looking at graphs of polynomial functions of higher degree. The goal will be to make a connection between the x-intercepts of the graphs and factors of quadratic expressions to polynomials of degree higher than 2. Alright, so let's say we have a function p of x where it's equal to x times the quantity x minus 8 times the quantity x plus 6. So this, you should see, is in factored form, and where the x-intercepts are is, well, we have a picture of the graph, but we should also know from factored form where the results are going to occur at. So the zero product property, if this was 0, so if x was 0, that would make all this 0. So that's that one right there. If x was 8, that would make this equal to 0. So that's why there's an x-intercept at 8. And if x was negative 6, there would be this quantity here would be 0, which makes everything 0. So factored form. No different than what it was with quadratics. We can apply it to a higher degree if it's all in factored form, and we got the x-intercepts there. Now, let's put this in standard form. So here's factored form. Let's convert that back to standard form. So I'd first probably distribute x times this, and this quantity, x minus 8. So this is going to become x squared, x times x, minus x times 8x, and then times the quantity x plus 6. So we have one more multiplication here. So we're going to get x squared times x, so x cubed, plus x squared times 6, okay, and then minus 8x times x, and then minus 8x times 6, which would be 48x. Okay, so this becomes x cubed minus 2x squared minus 48x. And that's what p of x would be equivalent to in standard form. Okay, let's say we have a polynomial function p that has x-intercepts at negative 2, 4, 3, 21, and negative 30. What is a possible equation for the function? And it's going to be easiest if we put this in factored form. So let's say our function p of x could be, well, if there's an x-intercept at negative 2, that means the factor would be x plus 2, the quantity x plus 2, because negative 2 would make that an x-intercept. Okay, now we have one at 4, so it would be x minus 4, because 4 minus 4 is 0. Then the next factor would be x minus 3, x minus 21, and then x plus 30. And that's a possible equation. Because what else could happen is there could be some a value up here, like let's say negative 2, and then the rest in factored form wouldn't change. So there could be some coefficient a value here, so that's why it's a possible function. Unless we had a picture and some other points on the graph, we wouldn't be able to figure out what that is. So that's why they say a possible equation, because there'd be an infinite number of answers, because a could be any number there. Rewrite the polynomial in standard form. So let's say r of x equals the quantity x minus 3 times the quantity 3x plus 2 times the quantity x plus 2, the quantity squared. So when we're multiplying this out to get it into standard form, we can multiply any two factors at a time because of the commutative and associative properties of multiplication. So what I would do first is probably expand the x plus 2 squared. So I'd say this is going to be quantity x minus 3 times the quantity 3x plus 2 times the quantity x squared plus 4x plus 4, if you remember how to expand that perfect square binomial. Alright, then I'd probably multiply these two together and get x times x, or x times 3x is 3x squared, plus x times 2 minus 3 times 3x, and minus 3 times 2 times the quantity x squared plus 4x plus 4. I need to simplify this first. 3x squared minus 7x minus 6 times the quantity x squared plus 4x plus 4. Alright, now I can do my final multiplication and get 3x squared times x squared, so it would be 3x to the 4th, plus 12x cubed plus 12x squared minus 7x cubed minus 28x squared minus 28x. Now I got to multiply the 6 through there too, so I'm going to get minus 6x squared minus 24x minus 24. Now I need to add and subtract like terms, put this in standard form. So 3x to the fourth, there are no other x to the fourth. So I have 3x to the fourth. I may cross this out as I use it. X cubes, there's going to be 12 and minus 7. So that would be plus 5x cubed. Okay, now the x squareds, and I have 12 minus 28. So that would be negative 16. And then subtract 6 more. So that would be negative 22x squared. Okay, and then I have minus 28x minus 24x, so that's going to be a minus 52x and minus 24. All right, and that is standard form. Now, you could use Wolfram Alpha, you could use a TI Inspire to expand that out, but most people don't have those readily accessible to you in the classroom, so we will have to know how to multiply these by hand, which is not a bad idea to know how to multiply polynomials like you've done before. All right, let's compare the graphs of y equals x times the quantity x minus 3 times the quantity x plus 5 and these other three. These are all the graphs in no particular order. So how do you know, without graphing each one, just by looking at them, what's the differences, what's the similarities? Well, right off the bat, you should know the similarities between them is these are all in factored form. All the x-intercepts are the same. They all cross at 0, 3, and negative 5. It's true on all these. 0, 3, and negative 5. So there's no difference between all of them in that aspect. But the way and shape they are is definitely different. Okay, now this one, as we look at the left behavior of this, it goes to negative infinity. We look at the right side behavior, it goes to positive infinity. Whereas this one on the left end goes to positive infinity and positive infinity. Same thing with these other two. Okay, so these are fourth degree polynomials, but this top one is a third degree, so it's a cubic. So which one of these, by knowing like if you expanded these and multiplied them, which ones would be fourth degrees, the bottom three would be. The top one has an x and x and x, so that'd be a third degree. So that matches with the first one. Now, the rest of these are fourth degree, so what is the difference? Well, the difference is where this squared term is at. The squared term here is on the x plus 5, it's on the x here, and it's on the x minus 3 squared here. So what is the difference? Well, those are turning points. So right here at negative 5 is a turning point, so it touches but does not cross. Same thing here at 0, it touches but does not cross, and same thing here on the 3, it touches it but does not cross. And you could probably guess which one matches up now. So the factor at negative 5 is that one because it touches but doesn't actually cross through on the x-intercept there. Okay, at the 0, so that would be this one where it touches but does not cross there at the x-intercept of 0. And over here it's on the x minus 3 term, so it would match with that one. Okay, so notice what the square does. It almost like it counts as 2 on the way down and on the way up, so it counts as 2 x-intercepts even though it's not, but that's a turning point. It doesn't cross through, it just touches. Okay, so give a possible equation in factored form for this polynomial here. So let's say it's some function p of x. And we have to know where the x-intercepts are at. And we know the left behavior goes to negative infinity, the right behavior goes to positive infinity. And what you know about cubics is positive cubics go like that. Negative cubics go of this form. So we know it's a positive and not a negative. So it's going to be some positive a value here, which we don't know, but we know we'll just leave it as a positive 1 for the moment. Okay, so we have an x-intercept at 0, so the x-intercepts are at 0, 2, and appears to be at negative 3. So that helps us with the possible equation. Well, if it's 0, that'd be like x minus 0, so we'll just leave it as x, times the quantity. Well, 2 is a x-intercept, so it'll be times the quantity x minus 2, and negative 3 is a factor, so it'll be times the quantity x plus 3, and that would be a possible equation in factored form for this picture here. Give a possible equation in factored form for a polynomial that would go through these particular 5 points. Okay, so our polynomial could look something like this. Okay, so let's say p of x is equal to, so now this opens up, so it's some positive a value here, so we'll just leave it as positive 1. Now the x-intercepts are at negative 8, negative 2, and 3. So the in factored form, this would be x plus 8 times the quantity x plus 2 times the quantity x minus 3. Now notice this is a turning point here. It doesn't actually cross through, so that needs to be a squared to make this a fourth degree and to match up with what you learned on the previous screen. Now what could also happen, this could be quite different. It could be a fourth degree that opens down. I could even show you that this could be a third degree. But let's say it's fourth degree, something like that. Okay, so we would have a negative number in front there, let's say negative 1, and then at 8 is a turning point, negative 8 is a turning point, so this would be the quantity x plus 8 squared, and then the other two would be x plus 2 times the quantity x minus 3. And you could get an infinite number of polynomials that go through those 5 points. But these are two possible ones. All right, so your assignment will be 12-7, page 758, 2 through 22 evens. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.